This is Jim Sawyer for CapitalismInCrisis.org. Fraud always involves deception. With increasing frequency, we are beset by fraud-laced schemes. Remember the Wells Fargo banking scandal in which 2 million fake customer accounts were created? Here's an even more jaw-dropping example of pseudo-capitalism from Germany. A man bombed a soccer team's bus, allegedly, but first he rigged the market. The perpetrator borrowed shares of a soccer team's stock, and then he bombed the team's bus, injuring one person. He assumed his bomb would trigger a drop in public confidence and therefore stock price. This should allow him to repay his recently borrowed block of shares with shares purchased at the now lower price. His expected profit? Over 1 million euros. This stock market trick is called selling short. Fortunately, detectives searching for the bomber wised up to his financial motive. Sometimes crooks act surprisingly like legitimate stock traders and corporate executives, and vice versa. See the link to the Wall Street Journal article below, and check out a helpful link to a Capitalism in Crisis podcast illustrating legal fraud. From Boulder, Colorado, this is Jim Sawyer for CapitalismInCrisis.org.